Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes sir, not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold, have a seat in the foyer. Take a number, I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder, thunder, thunder.
Hey Riley, what are you going to eat today?
What do you mean, Pat?
It's National Eat What You Want Day.
Stop. You're making me hungry. Let's just get on with the news.
Okay.
Congrats to the baseball team on their two wins yesterday. They 10-run Waconia in both games. Speaking of these fine young men, here is a hard-hitting feature story from Luke, Trevor, and Austin.
The 2018 Trojan baseball season has finally begun, so we asked coaches and players their goals for this season.
All right, well, the 2018 Trojan baseball season is here, and we really have kind of three big goals. Number one is to come to practice and games every day to compete, to win. Number two is to win the Wright County Conference, and number three is to compete for a section championship. Those are goals that the entire 9 through 12 baseball program developed early in the season and has committed to over the last 8 weeks.
Some of our goals this year are to have the will and want to win every game.
Yeah, every game. Every game.
Every game.
Another one is to win the Wright County Conference.
And to be section champions.
Yeah, that's right.
Yep.
The Trojans also gave their take on the weather this spring.
The weather doesn't affect us.
It doesn't.
We control the controllables. It's too easy.
CTC.
Every day.
Every day.
CTC.
So obviously the weather this spring has not been great. What we like to talk about is that every other team is in the same situation. Every team has had to practice inside for 6 weeks. And so how does that change the season? I think in terms of pitching, it's a big part of it. Most of our games have been changed to doubleheaders, which means you're playing 14 innings in one day. And then you might play another 14 innings 2 days later, and another 14 innings another 2 days later. So you have to be really deep. You have to have at least 10 to 12 pitchers that can throw at the varsity level in order to have enough pitching to get through games. And there are going to be times where a pitcher is not going to have his best stuff, but is going to have to continue to pitch because we may be out of pitching, or we need to save guys for the next game or for a few games down the road. The high school league has a pitch count rule, so that can make it really difficult to be able to use pitchers as kind of as you want to. You have to be safe with arms. So the weather makes it very difficult because our season has been very shortened because of the spring.
You may also hear a new addition to the program at games this year.
So Ben Bartuszek has been our PA announcer this year, and he has done an outstanding job. He's shown up early to every game. He's got the playlist ready to go. He's done a great job of announcing our lineups and announcing guys coming up to the plate. Now, I think he could improve a little bit on having maybe a little bit more energy. Ben just doesn't get real excited about things. So if you could get a little bit fired up for Trojan baseball, we'd really appreciate that.
Let's play ball!
So one day I'm just sitting eating my cold lunch, and Mr. Skogerbo comes walking up to me and says, "Hey, how would you like to announce this year for baseball? I figure you're going to be at all the games anyway." So I said, sure, and then next I know, Mr. Dubé is tweeting about me as the voice of the Trojans. So it's an absolute honor to be the voice of the Trojans this year, and I'm really looking forward to watching our team compete.
I'm a F-A-N-A-T.
All athletic and gym lockers need to be cleaned out by Thursday, May 24th, or your stuff will be discarded. See Coach Seymour for questions. Now, summer is a great time for soon-to-be juniors and seniors to explore college options. An easy way to get started is Minnesota Private College Week, June 25th through the 29th. These introductory campus visits, which include a campus tour and informational meeting, are of great value to students who are beginning their college search process. For details and info on how to register, go to the Counseling Office website announcement page or see your school counselor. Want to be on the Trojan Times staff next year? Yellow applications are in the forms rack by the office and are due this Monday, May 14th, to Mrs. Bishop, room 112. Current staff must reapply. Now, tomorrow is a big day. It is the Minnesota Fishing Opener. Also, girls golf is at the Marshall Invite at 8:30 a.m. Boys golf plays at Mankato East Invite at 9 a.m. And boys tennis is at St. James Quad at 9 a.m. Seniors, all 2- and 4-year colleges need a final high school transcript. Stop in the guidance office with your information ASAP. Here's Pat with the rest of the news.
Student council applications for the 2018-2019 year are in the forms rack outside of the office. If you are interested in being a member next year, please pick up your application now. The deadline is next Wednesday. Today, boys golf plays at Mankato East Invite at 8:30 a.m. Girls golf is at the Hutchinson Invite at 1. Baseball plays at Burnsville at 6:30, and softball plays at Prior Lake at 7. Good luck to all. What's on the menu today, Riley?
Mainline is offering cheese quesadillas, romaine lettuce, tomato and onion, salsa, sour cream, refried beans, and assorted fruit. And the high school grill today has cheeseburger or hamburger, assorted vegetables, french fries, sliced tomato, romaine lettuce, and assorted fruit.
We would like to wish a happy birthday to Isaac Jurek, Skylar Orth, and Carly Berglund. And happy birthday as well to the weekend birthdays, Sarah Brinkhouse, Erica Golson, and Brian Hennis. After this weekend, there's only one more weekend left of this school year.
So enjoy it. We'll see you back here on Monday. And go Trojans!
Yeah, go Trojans.